Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a relational databases in cloud computing, guys. So basically, whenever we want to store any kind of data, it might be numerical or it might be text format or any format, we commonly use a DBMS, right? That is, sorry, we'll be using databases, right? Yes. So we'll be using databases, like it might be SQL or any kind of database, Oracle SQL or anything. Okay. Yes. So basically, I think everyone knows about the concept of a whole relational databases, right? So basically, what is a database or a table, guys? So basically, the database, the data is stored in terms of a table. Okay. So it is divided into rows and columns. It will be having some attributes. Okay. So this is an example you can say, guys. Okay, so it will be having some attributes, and these are called as a tuples, guys. So each row you can say it as a tuple, and each column is an attribute, guys. Okay, yes. So, and I think everyone knows about the concepts, right? So we'll be having primary key, foreign key, super key, and all those things, right? Yes. Okay, so let us go through some theoretical part. I think you can just cover it from your previous knowledge, guys, because relational databases, we studied a whole subject, right? Yes. So a relational database is a data structure that allows you to link information from different tables or different types of data buckets. Okay. So one more thing that I forgot to say. So basically, once you form a table, it is a table, right? Yes. Similarly, if you form one more table, it is also one more table. Okay, so relational database means there should be some relation, right? Yes. So that relation, if you are establishing, so that this concept is nothing but relational database, guys. Okay, so basically here you will be having a primary key, and here you will be having a foreign key. So basically that is linked till here. So in that way you will be maintaining those links, guys. Okay, yes. Few examples will be MySQL, Oracle, DBMS, IBM, DB2, and few more. Okay, yes. Okay, so in this way I have just drawn it here, you can see. So basically we are having roll number here. Okay, so we are having the first main table is having roll number, name, and class. Okay, so one more table we are having, which is their father details and address. Similarly, we are having one more table, marks, average, and grades. So basically these kind of linkages. So basically if a student is having roll number 1, XYZ, and class is a second class, so in that way for roll number 1 he will be having a particular father name and address. Similarly, for that roll number 1, he'll be having his marks, average, and grade. So basically, in this way, so for that roll number 1 only, we are storing his data in multiple tables, and they are linked. So that concept is nothing but the relational databases, guys. Okay, yes. A scheme or design of databases is used to strictly define the table column indexes and the table definitions. Okay, so relational DB are usually used in enterprises, applications, or scenarios. Okay, MySQL is used mostly in web applications. Yes, it is used mostly in web applications, because the only main way of storing data in web is using databases, guys, because databases take really less amount of space, guys, when compared to normal text files or any other files. Okay, yes. Okay, so few advantages of RDBMS or relational database is the maintenance of it is really easy, guys. So it provides ease, usability. It allows a database administrator to maintain, control, update data in the databases easily with RDBMS backing up of data. Became easy. So basically everything is done really easily, guys. Okay, just the maintenance, any kind of admin things. So if he want to update some primary key, if he want to change the flow of those tables, their relations, everything could be changed really easily, guys. Okay, yes. So even in, I think so, in SQL, okay, so in MySQL, Oracle's MySQL, you can even draw them, guys, directly. So instead of creating table manually, you can draw them with the diagram. So basically, what is the relation? So based on that, the tables will be created and you can directly enter the value. So even those kind of tools are also available nowadays. So that much efficient and that much easy it is. Okay, yes. And the privileges, this future of RDBMS allows database administrators to control activities over the database. So basically here we'll be giving some permissions, guys. So basically we will be having some permissions. So the admin will assign these permissions, and whoever is having permissions, they can easily access the databases and they can modify also. So that is the one of the major important easy thing. Similarly, the data structure. So the data structure we'll be using in terms of a table, and we'll be filling it, right?
Yes.
And it is also flexible. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about RDBMS, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us discuss about content delivery network, guys. Guys, I think this topic is already covered in some other subject. Okay, so if I find it anyway, I will be adding before this lecture. And in the next lecture, let us revise it once again. There's no issue, right? It is really an interesting and easy topic. Okay, yes. So let us meet in the next lecture and discuss about this content delivery network. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching.